What up, bitches? It's the misanthropic one, aka He Who Hungers, and I'm back up in this bitch for another rant slash review. Today, I would love to talk about this album right here, Saigon's long-awaited debut called The Greatest Story Never Told. And I feel very honored to actually review this shit. And guys, forgive me, I'm a bit tired. I got work tomorrow, so I'm just doing this right before I'm going to bed. So figured I'd hit y'all with this. A lot of people were requesting this review. I was gonna do it because I've been waiting for this album for fucking years. For those who haven't heard of Saigon, he's an MC from New York. He's been doing his thing since, I want to say, early to mid-2000s, or last decade, I guess it's safe to say now. He's been putting his mixtapes out, you know, putting in his work. Some of his music caught the ear of the producer known as Just Blaze. He hooked up with Just Blaze, signed to his label for a minute, and they took it to Atlantic Records. That's where he was originally supposed to come out with this album, The Greatest Story Never Told. And for anybody who watches Entourage, that's what also helped him gain more of a buzz. Saigon was featured on a few episodes of Entourage, which is one of my favorite shows, by the way. If you don't watch that, go get them on DVD, go look them up on demand or whatever, but dope show. But this isn't about Entourage, it's about my man Saigon right here. And he had a few singles for this album, actually, which one of them is on here, Come On Baby, featuring Jay-Z and Swizz Beatz. That made it on here. But what was the other single, the other video? I think it was called Pain in My Life. Pain in My Life, yeah. That's what that single was called. I don't think that made it on here. Nah, that was featuring Trey Songz. That did not make it on this album. But his buzz was alive for a while, but this album suffered major fucking setbacks, and it actually pissed me off because, you know, I have some of his mixtapes, and I love his music, I love his lyrical content and shit. He's just everything I want an MC to have, he has. What else do I gotta say about him that y'all might need to know? Oh, also, in case you didn't notice, he also had a little beef with a Prodigy a couple years ago. Turned into a physical altercation where Saigon ended up punching Prodigy out. I forget where it was. It was somewhere in New York. I don't know if it was BB King's or not. Correct me if I'm wrong. I forget where the venue was. Saigon also had problem with Joe Button, but they squashed the shit, and I'm glad that both of them squashed it and actually made a song together. Check out that song. It's called Bring Me Down Part 3. It's not on this album. It's some internet single, I believe, but check that song out. The song is dope as shit. And I'm gonna get into this album real quick. Also, I mentioned his major setbacks with Atlantic. I think Saigon made a great career choice by jumping on Suburban Noise's record label. For those who never heard of Suburban Noise, that is a record label run by Brad Daddy X from the Cottonmouth Kings. And they've been hustling for years, and they put out work every year. Every year, Cottonmouth Kings are dropping an album or acts related to them. So they make sure that they do it independently. They make a lot of fucking money, and they got a definite hardcore fan base. So I believe Saigon made the right move, because I believe he was dropped from Atlantic, and he got with these guys. So he's independent, and he's gonna be making a lot of money if this shit sells, which it should. I mean, nowadays rappers, it's very hard for rappers to go platinum and shit. So if he does what, 100, 125, he'll be straight. So I hope Saigon makes it there. I hope he makes it past there, obviously. But let me talk about some of the production on the album. Well, right off the dick, most of this album was produced by Just Blaze. There was one song produced by Kanye called It's Alright. That was produced by Kanye. Red Spider produced on here. Who else? DJ Corbett. And there's some additional production on here. Oh, Buck Wild produced the song called Oh Yeah. I'm trying to find where the additional production was, because I remember I did read it earlier in here. Where the hell is it? Oh, we got SC. The song Give It To Me was produced by SC. I guess I must have misread, because the songs that Just Blaze didn't produce, he was on there as additional production. So yeah, that's that. Let's talk about some of the features on the album. We got Fat Man Scoop, Q-Tip, Swiss Beatz, Jay-Z, Faith Evans, Marsha Ambrosius from Flowetry, Raheem Devon, Devin the Dude, Lazy Bone, Bum B, and my man Black Thought from The Roots is also on this album on the secret track, track 18. So, got a fair amount of features on here. Other artists, and compliments the album, compliments Saigon real well. And yeah, that's it for features. Hang on one second.